各位亲爱的弟兄姐妹平安，欢迎您收看今天的空中主日崇拜节目。这个节目是由加略山华人基督教会为您所制作的，让我们存着敬畏和感恩的心，一起来敬拜这位三位一体的真神。
自耶稣来住在我心， Since Jesus came into my heart，
我的 wonderful change in my life has been wrought since Jesus came into my heart。 I have light in my soul for which long I have sought since Jesus came into my heart。 Since Jesus came into my heart。 Since Jesus came into my heart。 Fast of joy, oh my soul,停止流淌，不再做那迷途。自耶稣来住在我心，我的罪虽众多，主宝血已涂抹。自耶稣来住在我心，自耶稣来住在我心，自耶稣来住在我心。洗了草衣我回入海涛浪滚滚，自耶稣来住在我心。 I shall go there to dwell in the city I know since Jesus came into my heart。 And I'm happy, so happy as long when I go since Jesus came into my heart。Jesus came into my heart。 Thoughts of joy, oh my soul, like the sea billows roll。 Saint Jesus came into my heart。 我深知你我救主将永住难成，自耶稣来住在我心。我心中充满喜乐，勇敢往前行，住在我心。洗了草衣我回入海涛浪滚滚，自耶稣来住在我心。
我深信在那格格他山顶， I believe in a hill called Mount Calvary。
弟兄姐妹平安。
Peace be to you, brothers and sisters.
今天我要跟大家分享信息的题目是耶稣安慰怀疑的心。
The title of today's message is Jesus Comforts the Doubting Heart.
人信了主以后有时会怀疑。
After people believe and accept the Lord Jesus, they still have some doubts.
有的人怀疑神的救恩，说我真的得救了吗？
Some doubt their salvation, ask, am I really saved?
有的人怀疑神的应许，说神真的能使用我吗？
Some doubt God's promise, ask, can God really use me?
有人怀疑神的能力，说神真的能改变我吗？
Some doubt the power of God and ask, can God really change me?
弟兄姐妹，基督徒或多或少有一些疑问。
Friends, Christians will always have these kind of questions.
有时你遭遇一些事，心里想，神在这其中的目的是什么？
Sometimes you encounter something in life and think in your heart, what is God's purpose in all of this?
有的时候你问，神为什么沉默，没有听我的祷告？
Why is God silent and not listening to my prayers?
神为什么没有解决我的问题？
Why doesn't God solve my problems?
神为什么让我等这么久？
Why does God make me wait so long?
神为什么这样做而不那样做？
Why does God do something this way and not that way?
弟兄姐妹，人心里不明白，就会产生疑问。
Friends, it is natural for people to ask questions for things they don't understand.
在今天的节目里，我们要分享耶稣安慰怀疑他的人。
In today's message, I will share with you how Jesus comforts a doubting heart.
经文出自路加福音第七章十八到二十八节。
The scripture is found in Luke chapter 7, verse 18 to 28.
请听我读圣经的话。约翰的门徒把这些事都告诉约翰，他便叫了两个门徒来打发他们到主那里，说，那将要来的是你吗？还是我们等候别人呢？那两个人来到耶稣那里说，施洗的约翰打发我们来问你，那将要来的是你吗？还是我们等候别人呢？正当那时候，耶稣治好了许多有疾病的，受灾祸的，被恶鬼附着的，又开恩叫好些瞎子能看见。耶稣回答说，你们去，把所看见所听见的告诉约翰，就是瞎子看见，瘸子行走，长大麻风的洁净，聋子听见，死人复活，穷人有福音传给他们。凡不因我跌倒的就有福了。约翰所差来的人既走了，耶稣就对众人讲论约翰说，你们从前出去到旷野是要看什么呢？是要看风吹的芦苇吗？你们出去到底是要看什么呢？是要看穿细软衣服的吗？那穿华丽衣服咽了肚子的人是在王宫里，你们出去究竟是要看什么？是要看先知吗？我告诉你们，是的，他比先知大多了。经上记着说，我要差遣我的使者在你面前预备道路，所说的就是这个人。我告诉你们，凡妇人所生的没有一个大过约翰的，然而神国里最小的比他还大。
The scripture tells us the disciples of John reported to him all about these things.Summoning two of his disciples, John sent them to the Lord, saying, Are you the expected one, or do we look for someone else? When the men came to him, they said, John the Baptist has sent us to you, to ask, Are you the expected one, or do we look for someone else? At that time, he cured many people of diseases and afflictions and evil spirits, and he gave sight to many who were blind. And he answered and said to them, Go and report to John what you have seen and heard. The blind receive sight, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear.The dead are raised up. The poor have the gospel preached to him. Blessed is he who does not take offense at me. When the messengers of John had left, he began to speak to the crowds about John. What did you go out into the wilderness to see? A reed shaken by the wind? But what did you go out to see? A man dressed in soft clothing? Those who are splendidly clothed and live in luxury are found in royal palaces. But what did you go out to see? A prophet.Yes, I say to you, and one who is more than a prophet. This is the one of whom it is written, Behold, I send my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way before you. I say to you, among those born of women, there is no one greater than John. Yet he who is the least in the kingdom of God is greater than he.
弟兄姐妹，我们将从三个方面来分享以上的经文。
Friends, I will explain the above scripture from three aspects.
第一，约翰的疑问和解决疑问的方法。
First, John's doubt and how he tried to resolve his doubts.
第二, 耶稣回答约翰的问题。
Second, Jesus' answer to John's doubts.
第三, 耶稣安慰一切跟随他的人。
Third, how Jesus comforts all those who follow him.
以下我们思想信息的第一方面, 约翰的疑问和解决疑问的方法。
Now let's think about the first aspect, John's doubts and how he tried to resolve them.
很明显的,约翰的心里有一些疑问。
From the scripture, we see John had some questions on his mind.
但约翰不是怀疑神的真实或神的话语。
But John was not doubting the authenticity of God or the word of God.
他只是对一些事情感到困惑跟不确定。
He was uncertain and confused about something else.
那么约翰怀疑的原因是什么?
So what was the reason for John's doubt?
让我们先看约翰是谁。
Let us first look at who John is.
当时约翰已经是一个相当引人注目的人物。
John was a striking figure at the time.
他出来讲道的时候, 百姓是多么的兴奋。
When he came out to preach, many people came out and were excited to hear him speak.
约翰传讲悔改的信息。
John preached a message of repentance.
这信息非常有能力震撼全国上下的百姓, 甚至有人以为他就是神所应许的基督。
This message was very powerful and shook people all across the country. Some people thought he was even the Messiah promised by God.
但约翰立刻表明他不是基督,他只是基督的开路先锋。
But John immediately stated that he was not the Messiah, but the forerunner of the Messiah.
他是那旷野的人生,他的工作是预备主的道,修直主的路。
He was a voice in the wilderness. His role was to prepare the way for the Lord.
后来,主耶稣到约翰这里来,要受他的洗。
The Lord Jesus even came to John to be baptized by him.
约翰对耶稣说,我应当受你的洗,你反倒上我这里来吗?
When Jesus came to him, John said to Jesus, I need to be the one baptized by you, yet you still come to me.
主耶稣回答说,我理当这样尽诸般的义,约翰就为耶稣施洗。
But Jesus said to him, it is fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness in this way. After he said this, John baptized Jesus.
当耶稣从水里起来的时候,天忽然开了,圣灵仿佛鸽子降临在耶稣的身上。
After Jesus came up from the water, the heavens were suddenly opened, and the Spirit of God descended as a dove on Jesus.
天父又从上面宣告说,这是我的爱子,我所喜悦的。
As this was happening, the Heavenly Father declared, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased.
弟兄姐妹,约翰就是这样认识耶稣的。
Friends, this is how John came to know Jesus.
他对他的门徒说,你们应该跟随耶稣。 他是神的羔羊,他是那位除去世人罪孽的。
He said to his disciples, You should follow Jesus. He is the Lamb of God. He is the one who takes away the sins of the world.
因着约翰的见证,他的门徒就转来跟随耶稣。
Because of John's testimony, his disciples turned to follow Jesus.
所以约翰的一生为耶稣基督做出相当大的贡献。
So during John's lifetime, he made a considerable contribution to Jesus Christ's following.
但约翰人生最后的阶段是在监牢里面度过的。
However, during the last stage of his life, John spent most of it in prison.
当时希律娶了他哥哥的妻子做老婆,约翰为这件事大胆责备他,希律就将约翰下在监狱里,最后将他杀了。John
was put into prison and later killed because he rebuked King Herod for taking his own brother's wife as his own wife.
弟兄姐妹,这就是施洗的约翰。
Friends, this was the life of John the Baptist.
他在旷野在蓝天之下公开讲道。
He preached openly in the wilderness under the blue sky.
他的食物是蝗虫与野蜜。
He ate locusts and wild honey for sustenance.
他蒙神的呼召向百姓传讲悔改的信息。
He was called by God to preach the message of repentance to the people.
他的信息给全国带来史无前例的复兴。
His message brought unprecedented revival to the country.
但现在他为义受逼迫,被关在监牢的里面。
But he was persecuted for righteousness' sake and was put in prison.
这一切对约翰来说都是可以忍受的,因为在约翰的意识里,耶稣会来拯救他。
All this was bearable to John because in his mind, Jesus would come to save him.
约翰相信耶稣会使用权柄召集百姓推翻罗马的政权和统治,然后把他释放出来。
John believed that Jesus as the Messiah would gather the people and overthrow the power and control of Rome. He also believed that from all of this, he would be freed from prison.
但是18个月过去了，耶稣没有组织百姓起来推翻罗马政权。
But 18 months later, Jesus did not organize the people to rise up and overthrow the Roman rule.
耶稣没有鼓动政和对当时暴政的反对。
Jesus did not encourage any opposition to the tyranny of the Roman Empire.
耶稣没有制定任何政治计划。
Jesus did not enact any political plans.
耶稣似乎对组织集合群众的事漫不经心。
Jesus did not spend any efforts in organizing and gathering the masses.
约翰不禁自问，如果不推翻目前的暴政，如何建立新的秩序呢？
Amidst all of this, John couldn't help but ask himself,If the current government is not overthrown, how can a new and better order be established?
如果没有一个政策宣告，如何鼓舞民心呢？
If there's no public declaration, how can the people's hearts be inspired?
如果不借着一个组织，如何建立一个国度呢？
If there's no organization, how can a kingdom be built?
另外，有人对约翰说，耶稣接纳罪人，他被邀请到法利赛人家去吃饭，在听到的人中包括有税吏、有妓女，约翰一听，心里开始不舒服起来。
In addition, John had heard that Jesus was accepting of sinners, and he was even invited to the Pharisee's house to dine. Among the listeners were tax collectors and prostitutes. When John heard all of this, he began to feel uneasy.
他想，耶稣不是弥赛亚吗？
He thought, isn't Jesus the Messiah?
弥赛亚来不是要宣告神的公义吗？
Didn't the Messiah come to declare God's justice?
他不是来建立圣洁的国度吗？
Didn't he come to establish a holy kingdom?
他不是要使受捆绑的得自由吗？
Didn't he want to set the bound free?
他不是来伸张公义，为什么没有为我伸冤呢？
Why haven't I been shown justice?
他为什么没有使做监牢的得释放呢？
Why didn't he come to avenge me?
他为什么没有使做监牢的得释放呢？
Why hasn't he freed me from prison?
他心里因此产生很多疑问跟不确定。
Because of all of this, he had many questions and uncertainties in his heart.
他开始怀疑自己当初对耶稣的认识。
John began to doubt his original understanding of Jesus.
经文二十节说，施洗约翰因此打发门徒来问耶稣，那将要来的是你吗？还是我们等候别人呢？
Verse 20 tells us,John the Baptist sent his disciples to ask Jesus, Are you the expected one, or should we look for someone else?
弟兄姐妹，很明显的，约翰对主耶稣的使命和工作有所误会，有所不明白的地方。
Friends, obviously John misunderstood the mission and work of the Lord Jesus.
他误会耶稣所做的事，他误会耶稣所没有做的事。
What he expected Jesus to do, Jesus did not do. What he expected Jesus not to do, he did it.
但这误会是因为他对耶稣有一个预示的计划。
His misunderstanding was because he had a preconceived idea of what the Messiah was supposed to do.
这个误会是因为他对圣经认识不完全的结果。
This misunderstanding was the result of his incomplete understanding of the Bible.
其实，以赛亚书五十三章先预言主耶稣的受苦，六十章才开始预言他荣耀的再来。
Isaiah chapter 60 prophesies the return of the Messiah. But Isaiah 53 first prophesies that the Lord Jesus must suffer.
但是约翰在解释圣经上忽略了53章的预言。
But John ignored the prophecies in Isaiah chapter 53 and his interpretation of the role of the Messiah.
他忘记了基督在建立国度之前必须先为世人的罪受苦。
He forgot that Christ had to suffer for the sins of the world before he could establish his kingdom.
基督必须先替我们死在十字架上。
Christ must first die on the cross for us.
基督必须从死里复活。
Then Christ must raise from the dead.
基督必须先升天，最后基督才来到地上建立国度。
Finally, Christ would ascend to heaven before he would finally come back to earth to establish his kingdom.
但是约翰对主耶稣持守个人的见解。
But John had his own personal view of the Lord Jesus.
但事情不是如他所预料之中的时候，他就非常失望。
When things were not going as he expected, he was very disappointed.
然而，约翰在失望中做了一件正确的事， 就是他不要把问题存留在心中，却差派人来问耶稣，你是那将要来的那一位吗？还是我们等候别人呢？
However, in his disappointment, John still did the right thing. That is, he did not keep the doubts in his heart, but sent people to ask Jesus, are you the expected one, or do we look for someone else?
弟兄姐妹，今天我们有很多困惑我们的事，我们要学习借着祷告把事情带到耶稣的面前来。
Friends, there are many things that perplex us today. We must learn to bring these things before Jesus in prayer.
主一首圣诗说的，你就心里疲倦，沉闷叹息，应当告诉主耶稣。
There's a hymn that says, if you are weary and heavy-hearted, you should tell it to Jesus.
你若情不自禁，伤心流泪，应当告诉主耶稣。
If your tears flow down your cheeks unbidden, you should tell it to Jesus.
你若心中惧怕，死亡痛苦，你应当告诉耶稣，应当告诉主耶稣。
If you are troubled at the thought of dying, you should tell it to Jesus, the Lord Jesus.
以下我们分享信息的第二部分，耶稣回答约翰的问题。
Now let's go to the second aspect of the message, Jesus' answer to John's doubts.
你问约翰这样怀疑耶稣，耶稣如何帮助他？
You ask, John presented Jesus with his doubts, how did Jesus answer him?
首先，主耶稣没有责备他。
First, the Lord Jesus did not rebuke him.
耶稣本来可以说，约翰，你没有看到吗？
Jesus could have asked him, John, haven't you seen my work?
难道我的工作做得不够好吗？
Is my performance not good enough?
你不满意我的成绩吗？
Are you not satisfied with the results of my work?
弟兄姐妹，若是你和我，我们可能立刻火爆起来。
Friends, if it were you and I, we might immediately become angry.
但主耶稣一点也没有批评约翰，他没有对约翰讲任何负面的话。
But Lord Jesus did not criticize John at all. He did not say anything negative to John.
耶稣相反称赞约翰，因为主耶稣知道失望的痛苦和滋味。
On the contrary, Jesus praised John because the Lord Jesus knew the pain and feeling of disappointment.
第二，耶稣用事实安慰约翰，坚固他的信心。
Second, Jesus comforted John with the evidence of his work to strengthen his faith.
二十二节，耶稣对约翰的门徒说，你们去把所看见、所听见的事告诉约翰，就是瞎子看见、瘸子行走、斩大马蜂的捷径、聋子听见、死人复活、穷人有福音传给他们听。
In verse 22, Jesus said to John's disciples, Go and report to John what you have seen and heard. The blind receive sight, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear. The dead are raised up, and the poor have the gospel preached to them.
弟兄姐妹，耶稣对自己工作的描述说明他三方面特殊的身份。
Friends, Jesus' description of his work illustrates three special facets of his identity.
第一，耶稣是身体和心灵的医生。
First, Jesus is a physician to the body and soul.
他能赋予瞎子视力。
He can give sight to the blind.
他能赋予瘸子体力。
He can give strength to the lame.
他能赋予聋子听觉。
He can give hearing to the deaf.
他能洁净大麻风病毒，消除他们心灵的痛苦和羞耻。
He can heal leprosy and erase the pain and shame of the soul.
第二，耶稣是生命的主。
Second, Jesus is the Lord of life.
死亡是人类最后的敌人，是一切犯罪、疾病、悲伤的终局。
Death is the last enemy of mankind, the end of all sin, diseases, and sorrow.
但耶稣叫死人复活，他使绝望的重得希望，使伤心的得着安慰。
But Jesus can raise the dead. He can give hope to the despairing, comfort to the sorrowful.
他给人生命，给人机会。
He can give life and opportunity to people.
第三，耶稣是罪人的救主。
Third, Jesus is the savior of sinners.
他传福音给贫穷人听，使坐在黑暗里的人得见永恒的曙光。
He preached the gospel to the poor so that those in the darkness could see the eternal light.
弟兄姐妹，耶稣在这里间接告诉约翰，圣经论及我的工作，我一直都在做。
Friends, here Jesus told John directly that the Bible had already prophesied about his work and that he had already been carrying them out.
我的工作果效证明我的身份。
The effectiveness of my work proved my identity.
我的工作应验了旧约圣经对弥赛亚的预言。
My work fulfilled the Old Testament prophecy of the Messiah.
如果我不是圣经所预言的那一位， 谁能做这样的工作呢？
If I was not the one prophesied by the Bible, who could perform such works?
但我的工作不是领导革命，推翻罗马政权。
But my role was not to lead the revolution and overthrow Roman rule.
我的工作乃是使远离神的人归向神，是要使与神敌对的重新与神和好。
My role was to turn those who are far from God back to God, and to reconcile those who are hostile to God to find peace with God.
借着改变与神的关系，改变与人的关系。
By changing the relationship with God, the relationship with man will also change.
弟兄姐妹，今天我们也要借着耶稣的工作，认识耶稣的身份。
Friends, today we must also learn about the identity of Jesus through his work.
我们要想一想，世界上曾几何人，有一个人能做耶稣所做的事呢？
Let us consider this. Was there ever a person in the history of the world who could do what Jesus had done?
曾几何时，有哪一个宗教的创始人能叫瞎子看见、瘸子行走、长大麻风的洁净、聋子听见、死人复活、传福音给人听，并为罪人替死在十字架上，叫人因信他得称义、得救赎、得永远的生命？
Was there ever a founder of a religion able to make the blind see, the lame walk, the leopards clean, the deaf hear, and the dead rise? Who also could preach the gospel to people and to die on the cross for sinners, so that people could be justified by faith, be redeemed, and receive eternal life?
答案是否定的。耶稣基督是人类唯一的救主。
The answer is of course not. Jesus Christ is the only savior of mankind.
圣经说除他以外别无拯救，因为在天下人间没有赐下别的名我们可以靠着得救。
The Bible says there's salvation in no one else, for there's no other name under heaven that has been given among men by which we must be saved.
第三，耶稣请约翰继续的依靠他。
Third, Jesus asked John to continue to rely on him.
二十三节耶稣说凡不因我跌倒的就有福了。
Verse 23, Jesus saidBlessed is he who does not take offense at me.
这里耶稣对约翰说，你若不明白我做事的方法方式，请你凭信心依靠我。
Here Jesus said to John, if you don't understand the way I do things, please rely on me by faith.
你若不知道我做事的时间表，请你继续跟随我。
If you don't know the timetable for my work, you just need to continue to follow me.
我知道我在做什么，那继续凭信心寻找真理的人是有福的。
I know what I'm doing, and those who continue to seek the truth by faith are blessed.
弟兄姐妹，这也是神对我们的要求。
Friends, this is also what God requires of us.
我们虽然不完全明白神的作为，我们却必须用信心依靠他。
Although we do not fully understand what God does, we must rely on him with faith.
旧约的约伯就是这样，他失去财产，失去孩子，失去健康，他不知道为什么。
Job relied on God by faith. He lost his property, lost his children, and even lost his health. He didn't understand why.
但是约伯在受苦的日子里称颂神说，我赐生出于母胎，也必赐生归回。赏赐我的是耶和华，收取的也是耶和华。耶和华的名是应当称颂的。
But in his days of suffering, Job praised God, saying, Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked I shall return there. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
弟兄姐妹，这就是一个真基督徒的表现，这样信靠神的人是有福的。
Friends, this is the manifestation of a true Christian. Those who trust God in this way are blessed.
第四，耶稣在众人面前称赞约翰。
Fourth, Jesus praised John in front of the crowd.
第二十四到二十六节，耶稣说：“约翰比一个随着民意东歪西倒的政客更坚强，约翰比王宫里的王子更尊贵，约翰比众先知更伟大，因为约翰是属神的，是神特派的使者。”最后，耶稣强调说：“凡父神所生的，没有一个大过约翰的。”换句话说，约翰在所有先知中是最伟大的。
Verse 24 to 26 tells us, John is stronger than a politician who sways with public opinion. John is more noble than the prince in the palace, and John is greater than the prophets, because John is of God and is God's special messenger. Finally, Jesus emphasized, among those born of woman, there is no one greater than John. In other words, John was the greatest of all prophets.
哦，弟兄姐妹，约翰虽然在失望中怀疑耶稣，但耶稣仍然爱他。
Oh, friends, although John doubted Jesus and was disappointed in Jesus, Jesus still loved him.
耶稣给他的称赞是约翰一生从来没有想象过的。
The praise Jesus gave him was something no one ever had used to describe him.
讲到这里，你要问约翰为什么是这样伟大呢？
At this point, you may ask, what made John so great?
他没有写过一本书，他没有行过一个神迹，他的伟大表现在什么地方？
He had never written a book, nor ever performed a miracle. Where was his greatness?
答案是，约翰是耶稣基督的开路先锋，他的人生和事工像一个里程碑，为旧约制度画上了一个句号。
The answer is, John was the forerunner of Jesus Christ.His life and ministry were like a milestone that marked the end of the Old Testament and the beginning of the New Testament.
以下我们分享信息的第三部分，耶稣安慰跟随他的人。
Now let's go to the third aspect of the message. Jesus comforts all those who follow him.
当时在主身边的人听见论及约翰的话，心里可能产生另一个问题。
When the people around the Lord heard what John said, another question might arise in their hearts.
主啊，约翰这么伟大，信你的人如何呢？
Oh Lord, John is so great. How about the rest of us who believe in you?
耶稣说，约翰在旧约里虽然是最伟大的，但在神的国度里，最小的比约翰还大。
Jesus said, although John is the greatest in the Old Testament, the smallest in the kingdom of God is greater than John.
因为约翰是旧约体系里的一位先知，我们是新约时代的圣徒。
Because John was a prophet in the Old Testament era, but we are saints in the New Testament era.
约翰是君王的先锋，我们是君王的朋友。
John was a forerunner of the king, but we are friends of the king.
约翰是新郎的陪伴，我们是新郎的心腹。
John was the companion of the bridegroom, who is Christ. We, the church, are the bride of the bridegroom.
约翰出生在十字架救恩之前，我们出生在十字架救恩之后。
John was born before salvation by the cross. We were born after salvation by the cross.
并且因信基督住在我们的心里。
And by faith, Christ lives in our hearts.
弟兄姐妹，今天思想圣经的话就到这里。以下我们分享经文在生活上的一些应用。
Friends, today's message is concluded here.But I would like to share with you next some applications from the scripture that we can use to apply to our own lives.
总的来说，我们要全面学习圣经，正确解释圣经，借着祷告和圣灵的带领应用圣经。
We must study the Bible comprehensively, understand the Bible correctly, and apply through prayer and through the guidance of the Holy Spirit.
圣经对约翰说，我知道你的意思是要看见社会被改变。
Jesus said to John, I know you want to see society changed.
你要看见罗马政权被推翻，你要看见错误的被改正过来。
You want to see the Roman rule overthrown and mistakes corrected.
但我要改变世界，必须先进入世界，没有进入世界，就不能改变世界。
But if I want to change the world, I must first enter the world. I cannot change the world without entering the world.
这样耶稣把约翰带回圣经的里面去。
So Jesus brought John back to the Bible.
主的门徒对耶稣有的时候也有不明白的时候，是因为他们对圣经没有整体的认识。
The disciples of the Lord sometimes also didn't understand Jesus because they didn't have a comprehensive understanding of the Bible.
他们用自己的想法代替神的旨意，结果他们失望了。
They replaced God's will with their own misconceptions and thinking. As a result, they were disappointed.
主耶稣如何帮助他们呢？是把他们带回圣经的里面。
How could Jesus help them? By bringing them back to the Bible.
记得往以马忤斯的两个门徒，他们因为主耶稣被钉在十字架上，心里非常的沮丧。
Remember the story of the two disciples on the road to Emmaus? They're very despondent because of the crucifixion of the Lord Jesus.
但主耶稣来与他们同行。
But Jesus came and walked with them.
耶稣对他们说，无知的人啊，先知所说的一句话，你们的心信得太迟钝了。
Jesus said to them, O foolish men and slow of heart to believe in all that the prophets have spoken.
基督这样受害，又进入他的荣耀，岂不是应当的吗？
Was it not necessary for Christ to suffer these things and to enter into his glory?
于是从摩西到众先知起，凡经上指着自己的话，都给他们讲解明白了。
Then beginning with Moses and with all the prophets, Jesus began explaining to them the things concerning himself and all of the scripture.
他们听了主的话，心里就火热起来。
They heard what Jesus said and their hearts were burning within them.
弟兄姐妹，你要信心成长，你必须坚定在神的话语上面。
Friends, if you want to grow in faith, you must be firm in the word of God.
因为信道是从听道来的。
Because believing comes from hearing the word of God.
如果你不读圣经，不查考圣经，不让圣经向你说话，疑惑一定会产生，信心一定会动摇。
If you aren't reading the Bible, aren't studying the Bible, and aren't allowing the Bible to speak to you, doubts will surely arise, and your faith will be shaken.
让我举几个例子。记得在进驻2000年的前夕，人们最大的恐慌是2000年的电脑问题，叫 Y2K。
Let me give you a real-life example. Remember that on the eve of the year 2000, people's biggest panic was the Y2K computer problem. At that time, many people said the world is going to end here.
是的，当时人们很恐慌，说惨了，世界末日到了，一切的数据、资讯全都被混乱，水电、瓦气都要停止。
People were afraid that the data and information would be completely chaotic. Water, electricity, and gas would be stopped.
他们甚至说核子武器都要在这个时候全部爆炸。
They even said nuclear weapons would explode at this time.
有人因着着急要圣经的预言实现，就说夸大的话。
Some people spoke exaggerated words because they were eager to see the prophecies of the Bible come to pass.
有人迫切等候主再来，看见这些事就极其恐慌。
Some people were eagerly waiting for the Lord's return and were extremely panicked when they saw these things.
有的教会因此在这个时候开圣经预言讲座。
Some churches began holding seminars on Bible prophecy during this time.
他们说这是人类自我毁灭的时候了。
They said this is the time of human self-destruction.
后来我们平安进入新的禧年。
But then we entered the new year safely.
有人就质疑说神为什么还没有来呢？
Some people questioned, why hasn't God come yet?
他的应许为什么没有实现呢?
Why is his promise not fulfilled?
其实圣经根本没有提及主来跟2000年电脑的问题，这是人们错误解释圣经引起的。
In fact, the Bible did not mention the issue of the Lord's coming with regards to the year 2000 computer problem. This was caused by people misinterpreting the Bible.
今天的确有人自己误解圣经，然后埋怨神说神没有实现他的应许。
Today there are indeed people who misunderstand the Bible and then complain that God has not fulfilled his promise.
另外，今天在电视上有一些叫信心讲员常常在混乱基督教的信仰。
In addition, today on TV there are so-called faith speakers who often confuse people's Christian faith.
他们说神要每一个信徒都兴旺发达。
They say God wants every believer to prosper.
神不要你贫穷，神不要你生病。
They say God doesn't want you to be poor. God doesn't want you to get sick.
你信了主就不会欠债，信了主就不会生病。
They say if you believe in the Lord, you will not owe debts. If you believe in the Lord, you will not get sick.
结果有人以为信了主，主一定保守他不遇试探，不遭艰难。
As a result, some people think that if they believe in the Lord will definitely protect them from temptation and suffering.
可是一旦吃货发生在一个敬畏神的人身上，他们就说，为什么是这样呢？神不是保护义人吗？
But when a car accident happens to the person who fears God, they say, why did this happen? Doesn't God protect the righteous?
或一个孩子死了，或一个忠心服侍主的弟兄得了癌症，他们就问，神为什么许可这样的事发生在人的身上呢？
Or when a child dies, or when a person who is faithfully serving the Lord gets cancer, they ask, why does God let such things happen?
弟兄姐妹，圣经不是像那些信心讲员所说的。
Friends, the Bible is not like what these faith speakers describe.
圣经来告诉我们，神能医治人的疾病，神也要我们生病的时候求告他。
The Bible tells us God can heal people's diseases. God also wants us to call upon him when we are sick.
另外，圣经没有说基督徒都要成为千亿万富翁。可是有人就是偏偏喜欢去相信这种错误的说法。
But the Bible does not say that God must heal all those who are sick. God's will sometimes allows diseases to come to people.
另外，圣经没有说基督徒都要成为千万富翁，可是有人就偏偏喜欢去相信这种错误的说法。
Furthermore, the Bible does not say that all Christians will become wealthy. Yet some people just love to believe this false teaching.
结果有人生病了，贫穷了，他们就开始埋怨神。
As a result, when someone is poor and sick, they begin to blame God.
他们说神没有成就他的应许，我灰心了，我要离开主。
They say God has not fulfilled his promise. I'm discouraged. I'm going to leave the Lord.
弟兄姐妹，这种常常埋怨神的人，是因为他错误理解圣经造成的。
Friends, these types of people who often complain about God have misinterpretation of the Bible.
今天人们也常常误会教会的使命跟功用。
Today, people often misunderstand the mission and function of the church.
有人以为教会的使命是改变国家、改变文化、改变社会。
Some people think that the mission of the church is to change the country, change the culture, and change society.
他们说教会应该走在时代的前面，领导潮流，所以我们要参政，我们要选举。
They say that the church should be leaders in society, that it must be the trendsetter, so we must participate in politics and elections.
这固然没有错，因为主耶稣要我们在地上做光做盐。
These things are all good and fine, because the Lord Jesus wants us to be light and salt in this world.
盐的功用之一是防止肉类的腐烂，教会的功用之一也是防止道德的腐烂。
One of the functions of salt is to prevent the rotting of meat. One of the functions of the church is to prevent moral decay in society.
所以我们不但有权利选举，我们更有责任选举，我们还要选一位持守圣经原则的领袖。
So not only do we have the privilege to vote, but it's also our responsibility to vote. We have to choose a leader who adheres to the principles of the Bible.
但是选举不是教会最重要的使命。
But voting is not the most important mission of the church.
教会的使命是改变生命。
The mission of the church is to change lives.
要改变生命，我们必须传福音。只有耶稣基督的福音能拯救人类。
In order to change lives, we must preach the gospel. Only the gospel of Christ can save mankind.
最后，主耶稣要我们凭信心跟随他。
Lastly, the Lord Jesus wants us to follow him by faith.
今天如果有人怀疑神在你生命中的目的和时间，请你记得耶稣对约翰说的话，不要因他跌倒。
If anyone doubts God's purpose and timing in their life today, please remember what Jesus said to John. Blessed are those who do not fall because of me.
因为现在我们所看见的不都很清楚。
Because we can't always see clearly what is happening at all times.
有时我们不明白神为什么要这样做。
Often we don't understand why God does certain things a certain way.
但圣经说有一天我们要看得清楚。
But the Bible says that one day we will see clearly.
弟兄姐妹，我们要知道有一些事情神没有给我们答案。
Friends, we need to know that in certain things God has not yet given us the answer.
无论你如何努力，就没有些就没办法得着答案。
No matter how hard you try, you will not be able to find the answer.
因为在天这边的人不能知道天那边的事。
Because people on this side of heaven cannot know things on the other side of heaven.
所以有一些事你要把它放在一边，等候神施恩的日子来到。
So there are certain questions that you have to put aside and wait for the day of God's mercy to come for them to be answered.
有的时候你20岁的问题要等到30岁才得着答案。
Sometimes, your question from when you are 20 years old may not receive an answer until you are 30.
你30岁的问题，有的时候要等到50岁才找到答案。
And questions from when you are 30 years old may not be answered until you are 50.
还有一些问题要等到天上的时候，神才让你明白。
There are still yet some questions God will only let you understand when you get to heaven.
对于没有答案的问题，神要你信靠他。
For questions that have no answers, you have to trust in God.
弟兄姐妹，你心里有一些疑问吗？请你把它带到主耶稣的面前来。
Friends, do you have questions in your heart? Please take them to Jesus.
可能是你误解神的意思，解决的方法是正确的、全面的认识圣经。
It may be that you may misunderstand what God means. The solution is to understand the Bible correctly and comprehensively.
或者你的优先次序颠倒了，你要到神的面前来，让他矫正你的次序，让他把你重新带回自己的话语里面。
Perhaps your priorities are upside down. You have to come before God and let him correct your priorities so that you can bring you back to his word.
记得有一天神要亲自回答你所有的问题。
Remember that one day God will answer all your questions personally.
今天的信息就分享到这里。
This concludes the message for today.
弟兄姐妹，我们一起低头接受神所要给我们的祝福。
Brothers and sisters, let's bow our heads. Let's receive the benediction from the Lord.
但愿天父的慈爱，
Now may the loving kindness of God the Father,
我们主耶稣基督的恩惠，
And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
和圣灵的交通，
And the fellowship of the Holy Spirit,
每一天每一个时刻 都与弟兄姐妹同在。
Be with brothers and sisters every day and every moment.
直到我们主耶稣基督回来的日子。
Until the day Jesus Christ returns back for us.
愿主牵着您的手。
May the Lord hold your hand.
每一天与你同行。
And may the Lord walk alongside with you daily.
愿他安慰你。
May the Lord comfort you.
扶持你。
May the Lord uphold you.
坚固你。
May the Lord strengthen you.
保护你。
May the Lord protect you,
医治你。
May the Lord heal your sickness.
给你一切的力量、智慧、资源来为主而活。
And to live a life for God with all His resource, His power, and His wisdom.
在生活中活出见证。
And to live a testimony in daily living.
结出圣灵的果子。
And to bear the fruits of the Holy Spirit.
来荣耀三位一体的真神。
To bring glory to God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit.
主必与你同在。
The Lord shall be with you.
从今时直到永永远远。
From now unto eternity.
但愿在至高之处荣耀归于三位一体的真神。
And now may glory to the triune God in heaven.
归于圣父、圣子和圣灵。
Glory to God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit.
地上平安归于所有的弟兄姐妹。
And peace on earth be to all brothers and sisters.
就是一切爱慕他显现的人。
It's all the brothers and sisters who are waiting for the appearing of God.
奉靠主耶稣基督的名。
We bless in Jesus Christ's name.
Amen.
Amen.
各位朋友，谢谢您收看今天的节目，愿上帝赐福给您。我们下周同一时间空中再会。